That's weird. I thought we were indoors still. I hear this dragon inside of a Dwemer ruin. That's impossible. I can't see squat.
Why don't you crawl back into the egg?
So we're leaving the afflicted area. Trying to.
Come on, show me how brave you are.
I still have pictures to take and places to loot and explore around here. Waiting for the sun to come out. Hey, where'd the dragon go? Oh, I hate when the dragon does this. It flies away somewhere or dies somewhere, and I don't know where. I don't know where it flew off to. Because when the dragon hits the ground, it's dead. And I don't see a dead dragon. Or a dying dragon anywhere. See a lot of goats and wolves. Anyway, so I'm just kind of like looking around. I vaguely know this area of Markarth, or the Reach, as they call it. I thought there was another way out, but I mean, there's a few ways out of this place, but I thought I'd go out the front door in case it's supposed to trigger some sort of encounter as you leave the place. A final goodbye. From a ghost child waiting outside. No ghost child in this quest. No ghost afflicted kid who's a vampire. Who has godlike powers. Nothing like that at the end of this quest. I wasn't even sure if I was supposed to talk to Periite. But I think if you want the shield, I think you have to go back and talk to him. Talk to his rat.
Oh,
minions.
Sorry. Oh, sorry.
Really? Separation issues, Dewey? Okay, that dragon is nowhere around. It just... If it died, it blended in with the landscape really good. So I'm just taking pictures as I'm looking at the skyline. I still get a kick out of, you know, how something looks really far away, and as you run just to maybe 10 or 12 steps towards it, you're there. And it wasn't really that far away. The Skyrim is what? Only 6 miles across? Maybe less? It's kind of a sandbox. I want to pretend it's a sandbox, but it's kind of not a sandbox. It's more like a theme park. The same encounters over and over and over again. So you keep installing more mods to make Skyrim more interesting or surprising. More variety. Whoa! Lucky hit! I guess I had no stamina left to even do a block. I got my HUD turned off so I don't see what any of my attributes are set at any moment. Oh, yesterday I found out that my Draugr have no subtitles. I've been playing Skyrim forever, and I haven't had any subtitles for my Draugrs. Because I'm watching people's Skyrim games on YouTube, and it's like, their Draugrs talk. I mean, my Draugrs talk too, but I just don't have subtitles for them. So now I'm in search and rescue mode. No! Trying to figure out what mod I have installed that's canceling out Draugr subtitles in my game. Because I do have Draugr replacement for audio. So I've been going through those mods, and it looks like... Oh, that's a cool picture right there to take. The sun's coming up, and it's hitting the ground just a certain way, so I got some shadows going on, some color going on. Sky's turning blue. But yeah, the Draugr mod I'm using only changes the WAV files for the audio. It doesn't change any scripts or anything. So it's not my Draugr mods that are doing it. And I don't think Fusrodo or Fusrado would be... Oh, I can't go any farther. What? I can't go any farther. But I want to go to the edge of the edge of Skyrim. I want to go there. Oh, I'm getting frame rate issues. I should probably head back before my companions lose their mind. Where did he go? How did he even get there? He jumped the mountain. Instead of jumping the fence, he jumped the mountain. Oh, there they are. You guys are still lollygagging. I'm just seeing if I can climb a wall like Spider-Man does. Nope, don't lock up on me. Oh, don't lock up on me. Don't fail me now. Oh. Up, up, up. Okay, I'm heading down. I'm heading down. My companions are having issues with nav meshes trying to keep up with where I'm going. Eating up all my game CPU time. We're back here again. We haven't gone anywhere. Okay, now what's interfering with my game? Well, that looks neat. That fog up there. So I suspect, you know, since Fusrodo is not messing up with my... I don't think that mod would be messing with my Draugr's subtitles. I'm guessing it's my People Are Strangers. It modifies how subtitles are shown on the screen. And maybe There's some clipping going on when it comes to Draugr. The mod just sort of aborts displaying a comment or a dialogue of any kind from Draugr. So I'm gonna go scream and yell, make noise about a mod that hasn't been updated in 6 years probably. Just on the off chance that somebody will update the mod out of the blue for Draugrs to work right. I should do that now, while I'm thinking about it. Okay, I left a message on the board. Maybe someone will have the same issue I'm having and put two and two together, come up with five, and they'll be like, let's fix this mod. This mod hasn't been fixed in, 5 years. Ooh, can I kill it with a shield? I guess not. So I can't kill with my shield yet, for some reason. Maybe I just didn't have enough stamina. It's hard to tell. Without a HUD, it's hard to tell what's going on in my game. It's too immersive. Immersive meaning confusing. So I'm just taking pictures. Oh, got some Forsworn fighting somebody. What's going on over there? Stay out of my frame, people. I'm trying to take pictures here. Yeah, it looks like the fight's over. That looks like, a Thalmor doing something with the Forsworn. Did I say Falmer? I meant to say Forsworn. Anyway. And all of the Reach.
Yes?
I don't know why there's friendly Forsworn in my game. I just don't understand this.
Yes? I'd better get going.
Oh, a goat killed somebody. Yeah. What's that mod I'm using? Sky Test.
Move along.
Adds killer goats.
Walk away, now.
Oh, here's an. Oh, they're fighting Stormcloaks. So the Forsworn just... Forsworn are killing goats. The Thalmor are killing Stormcloaks.
Walk away now.
It's like rock, paper, scissors around here. Who's that? Who's that? Orc hunters.
Move along. Walk away now. Walk away. Walk away now.
Yeah, orc hunters used to attack me, they used to attack each other, but now orc hunters just kind of stand around.
This better be good.
What made you decide to become an orc hunter? Oh, I wanted to see the world. I wanted to hunt things as an orc. My ma and pa did the same as well. And then they're like, this is so boring. Orc hunting is so boring. There's nothing to do. Oh yeah, up here is a, I want to say the mother? the wisp mother things, but, oops, sorry, I didn't mean to step on your hooves. Yeah, there's no wisp mothers. I think they only spawn one time, and then that's it. My wisp mothers have breast assists. Because mods. I was trying to think why they have breast assists. It's probably just mods. I blame the mods. So I'm still looking for that stupid dragon I killed. Anyway. Enough lollygagging.
Yes?
What are you doing?
It burns.
Making sure you're not vampires.
It burns.
Can't be too careful.
So welcome to Fort Dawnguard. I'm sure you've heard a bit of what we're up against. Powerful vampires, unlike anything we've seen.
I'm so glad that we're traveling to Elidium Sanctuary together.
Where's the rest of your
accoutrements? All alone.
This is all well and good.
If you say so.
Yeah, that's better.
We'll get to that. For now, get acquainted with the space. Sorin, you'll find room to start your tinkering on that crossbow design you've been working on. Gunmar, there's an area large enough for you to pen up some trolls. Get them armored up and ready for use. In the meantime, we're going to get to the bottom of why a vampire showed up here looking for you. Let's go have a little chat with it, shall we?
Let's.
Isn't exactly a palace, is it? Still, it's sturdy, secure, and seems defensible. I suppose I'd rather be here than most other places in Skyrim. If Thrawn needs me, it must be pretty bad. I wonder what we're up against here. I want to add some punch to our crossbow capabilities. I've done all I can on my own. I need a little inspiration. I've always been fascinated with Dwemer artifacts. I take them apart, poke around in their guts, and try to figure things out. With mixed results. But as luck would have it, I've tracked down the location of some actual Dwemer diagram drawings. So, if you'd be a dear and collect those plans for me? A basic one, of course. That is, assuming you know anything about steelsmithing. It's pretty simple. Talk to Gunmar if you need materials. Until next time.
I don't remember if I took pictures of this place already, but I'll do it again, since it's probably a different time of day in here.
Here we are. It begins again. I fear for what is to come. Working metal isn't easy. Let me show you a few things.
I noticed I could buy a troll from
Sorin
him.
Sorin needs help with her project to improve our crossbow.
Before there's any trolls to be bought.
Speak with Ysran.
Like the troll pin for you. Is empty, but yet he sells me a troll.
Take care of yourself.
See, there's no troll here, right? There's nothing. No armored trolls. So I save the game first in case I crash Skyrim.
Cozy little place, isn't this?
Then I ask him about buying a troll.
Aye, lad. All right. I'll take note. He'll mind you and us Dawnguard, but there's no accounting for other folk. And heed also this. He's no pet. Mistreat the beast or leave him alone for too long, and he'll return to the wild, forgetting you ever existed. Now, you be careful with the creature.
And there's the quantum troll. I didn't know that was a thing in Skyrim, but I guess it is.
Keep your neck covered.
Oh, so there's a group of YouTube watchers out there.
Yeah.
That absolutely hate.
Fight well.
That I'm doing letterbox with my Skyrim. They just hate it. So I say to thee, there are hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of other Skyrim videos on YouTube that don't have letterbox. Maybe you should watch those instead, but no, they're not satisfied. They won't be happy until all Skyrim videos on YouTube have no letterbox. Those people are the control freaks on the interwebs. And of course, you go to their YouTube channel, they've got nothing. No subscribers, no videos. So it's like, who are they exactly? They're nobodies.
So let's hear it.
Well, let's take a picture of these two.
You probably weren't expecting to see me again. I'd rather not be here either, but I needed to talk to you. It's important, so please just listen before your friend here loses his patience. It's... well, it's about me. And the Elder Scroll that was buried with me. The reason I had it, and why I was down there, it all comes back to my father. I'm guessing you figured this part out already, but my father's not exactly a good person, even by vampire standards. He wasn't always like that, though. There was a turn. He stumbled onto this obscure prophecy and just kind of lost himself in it. It's pointless and vague, like all prophecies. The part he latched onto said that vampires would no longer need to fear the sun. That's what he's after. He wants to control the sun. Have vampires control the world. Anyway, my mother and I didn't feel like inviting a war with all of Tamriel, so we tried to stop him. That's why I was sealed away with the scroll. I'm sorry. I had heard there were vampire hunters here. I thought they might want to know about a vampire plot to enslave the rest of the world. Was I wrong? Well, let's move then. I'm nothing if not persuasive.
All right, you've heard what it has to say. Now tell me. Is there any reason I shouldn't kill this blood-sucking fiend right now?
Why? Because of that story about the prophecy, about some vampire trying to put the sun out?
Do you actually believe any of that?
I do.
Who knows? Maybe it has a death wish. Maybe it's just insane. I don't really care.
It's really easy to convince Isran.
But if it so much as lays a finger on anyone here, I'll hold you responsible.
I wish there was more dialogue to get Isran to change his mind.
You feel like a guest because you're not. You're a resource. You're an asset. In the meantime, don't make me regret my sudden outburst of tolerance and generosity. Because if you do, your friend here is going to pay for it.
Thank you for your kindness. I'll remember it the next time I'm feeling hungry. So, in case you didn't notice the giant thing on my back, I have the Elder Scroll with me. Whatever it says, it will have something that can help us stop my father. But, of course, neither of us can read it. Well, the Moth Priests are the only ones I've heard of who can do it. They spend years preparing before they start reading, though. Not that it helps us anyway, because they're all half a continent away, in Cyrodiil.
Some Imperial scholar arrived in Skyrim a few days ago. I was staking out the road when I saw him pass by. Maybe that's your Moth Priest.
Do you know where he's staying now?
No, and I'm not going to waste men looking. We're fighting a war against your kind, and I intend to win it. You want to find him? Try talking to anyone who'd meet a traveler. Innkeepers and carriage drivers in the big cities, maybe. But you're on your own.
Any idea how you're going to find a moth priest? Skyrim's a pretty big place. Well, back before I... you know. The College of Winterhold was the first place I'd think to go for any kind of magic or historical thing. The wizards know about all kinds of things that people probably shouldn't know about. I'd come with you, but I don't know if I can trust your friend. Let me know if you want me along. If you want to come along, it has to just be me and you. If you want to come along,
okay.
Just be me and you.
So we're back to that follower scheme again. So I guess Janasta has to be sent home.
Yes? Of course.
So, where are we going now?
Oh, she doesn't have any regular shoes?
We've stopped. What is it? It's the least I can do. Let's go.
What are we supposed to do? The whole moth priest thing, I usually trigger that by accident, by talking to somebody. I'm not even thinking about the quest, and somebody just says, "It was the talk of the town when the moth priest came by." Let's take some pictures while we're here. That's cool. The sky changed color up there.
If you want to come along, it has to just be me and you.
My last ENB, the sky never changed. No matter what time of day it was, and you'd look up through the hole up there. So slowly but surely, I'm starting to like this ENB.
What awful weather. Sure.
So we're gonna go meet up with Hadvar.
Oh, sorry.
I'm doing too many quests at once here. I'm still doing the Civil War quest, which I can't stand. It's the dumbest thing ever. But you gotta do it. Gotta do it. Unless you want to do Unending Season. I don't want to do Unending Season.
Well, well, look who it is. How have you been? These are dark days, but at least we know we're doing our part to make things better. I guess I'm doing all right. I need this to go well. This is my first real command since they promoted me after Whiterun. You know, some nights when I close my eyes, I see the battle stretched out before me, like I'm still there. Do the men you've killed haunt you? Mine do.
Milk drinker.
That's what I keep telling myself. But never mind all that. What brings you out this way? Really? It just so happens we've been tracking a wagon for about a day now. So that's what's in there. Coins and weapons. How do you know that? Oh, fine. Keep your secrets. I see how it is. That wagon recently had a little accident. They're stranded now, just up the road. We're outnumbered, but I have a plan. You got here just in time. First, we're going to take out the sentry. Then we'll situate ourselves overlooking the camp. Next, you'll infiltrate the position and get their attention, while we hit them with a barrage of arrows. With a bit of luck, we'll catch them completely off guard and even the odds a little. Good. There's a sentry patrolling the hill. We'll go in quiet and drop him with a combined arrow barrage.
I usually die in this quest because I'm too busy trying to act all heroic while I'm videotaping, and I get bushwhacked. You know, something stupid happens, like I clip on something.
Hi.
I'm in crossfire.
Of course.
Vilya Ninja kills things in front of me, and I don't know who I'm shooting at in the dark. You know,
all anytime. Kind of,
all that stuff happens. It's just chaos. It's never organized war. Never. Okay. What mods do I have installed since the last time I had to do this quest? It's always different how this ends up.
Fire! Hello, friend.
Hello, friend. Hello. Hello, old friend. Goodbye, old friend. Oh, man.
Alright, you infiltrate their camp, we'll cover you from the ridge.
Maybe the arrows? Why wasn't I... Usually I can do a one-shot kill, but I guess my arrows aim different than they were before. Let's see about this guy here. Oh, he moved! Man, I am sucking. What's going on over here? Don't kill my troll. Don't kill my troll. He killed my troll. Trolls are kind of... Oh! My troll lives? So there will be a Trolls 3 film.
Quite a team, eh? I'll stay here and guard the shipment. You get back to camp with the news. Have them send some men with a new wagon. This one isn't going anywhere.
Watch what happens. Boof! I hate that. Don't you hate that? You're not supposed to see that. The caravan disappeared. The treasure disappeared. The men disappeared. Everything disappeared. That sucked.
Well met. Talk later.
Now, if you open the chest before you talk to Hadvar, you'll find gold ingots and weapons. Stuff that's just too heavy to carry. Well, there's one of those evil goats that likes to kill people. put it out of my misery. I don't know why, but I was in the mood to visit Gold Deer. So he'll show up in the next video. Oh, now we got these Imperials, these broken Imperials. Waiting for a battle that's just not gonna happen. They keep spawning here without any storm cloaks to fight.
Keep an eye out for trouble.
Yeah,
it's only a matter of time.
Until next time.
Well, I don't see any storm cloaks nearby. I usually kill the captain just for the heck of it, thinking, oh, maybe they'll go away if he dies, but nope. Someone else takes his spot. But, you know, I've long since removed the immersive patrols and installed an older version that worked. So now everything's hunky-dory once again in my game. I keep poisoning my weapons because it helps to lose weight, getting rid of some of the, I have so many poisons, I need to start using them. Settle down, you guys. They always go into overkill mode. It's weird. Sometimes I can take the shrouded armor off the assassin, and sometimes I can't. Wonder why that is. I wanted to see her feet, if she had Khajiit feet or not. I mean, I'm guessing she does. Anyway, let's go visit Gold Deer, just because.